Governments in India have come primarily from two sections. They have come from either the Congress party or its leaders, those who were in power and did not undertake any reforms or changes, maintained the status quo and gave to this country a government which was known for policy paralysis. Or they have come from those who were in the BJP and for some reasons are not very happy today, not for any ideological reasons. The immaturity of those reactions is that when you undertake major structural reforms, India is in a situation that we are growing between 7% and 8% 3 years in a row, which is the highest growth rate any major economy had. And therefore, that is what gives you the confidence to undertake structural reforms. You can slip by a percentage point or so for a quarter or two, and then you can pick up again. So these are challenges of a transient nature. A GST is bound to throw up a challenge in a transient nature, because local manufacturing will come to, will dip a little, because people will destock. And then once the new tax regime comes into play, they'll start manufacturing in the new tax regime. Same is the position when you switch over and try and formalize the economy by assaulting a shadow economy by a major step like demonetization. You'll have a gap period itself. Now, this gap period is not going to be years. This gap period doesn't take your economy into the negative area. You still remain a high 5.7, 6.1% for one or two quarters. And thereafter, you start catching up again. And it's quite evident that now every indication which is coming indicates exports growing by 26%, PMIs in services and manufacturing both turning positive, IIP figures are good, inflation figures are moderate, core sector growth is reasonably high, and therefore these are all indications of a higher level of growth returning back to India. These are preliminary indications, but nonetheless important indications. And if this is coupled with the fact that growth is returning to the world, and therefore that's going to impact two sectors. One is demand, and one is exports.
Right.
And both of which are vital as far as India is concerned.